What is up, beautiful people? Corwin L. Gilliams here from CLG Lifestyle. Hope you guys are feeling blessed and grateful to be alive. Don't forget to subscribe to the YouTube channel right now. That way you can stay connected to what it is that I'm doing as a lifestyle influencer slash life coach slash content creator slash servant of the Most High God. For those of you who don't know, I have a podcast as well. It is in the description box with the free ebook that I have as well. For you guys out there who are seeking to discover who you are in God as far as your identity God created, not the identity the world created, not the identity that your trauma and your past experiences created, not the identity that you created in order to put on a facade and to, you know, create a persona that you believed would make you acceptable and pleasing to people. And so this ebook is going to help you, one, discover how valuable it is to embody who God created you to be, even though the world and, you know, culture and society says, you know, that you shouldn't be yourself, quote unquote, your God designed self. In the book, you know, I reveal to you the importance of being your God designed self, because that's where your power is at. That is where you're going to thrive. Anything else is oppression. Anytime you're being someone that you're not, it's a form of oppression, and it's not going to profit anything other than rob you of your peace, rob you of your joy. You're going to spend time cultivating relationships with people who don't know the true you, who don't want to know the true you, because that's not who you're presenting. That's not who you're giving the people an opportunity to know. So this is why you can have a lot of people around you, but you have no peace. This is why you can have a lot of people around you, but you have no friends. This is why you can have a lot of people around you and they serve no purpose but to steal, kill, and destroy the plans of God that you have for your life. And it's not that they're doing it intentionally. It's that you yourself are sabotaging your destiny and your life. And so this book, a quick read, 16 pages, is going to help you, again, lovingly discover the importance of loving yourself. It's going to, you know, give you more insight on who God is. God is love, but you know, we all have different experiences. We all come from different backgrounds, and we've all been taught about God, you know, in ways that isn't necessarily who God is. And so I petition you, with this book, along with your own special interest, that you discover who God is for yourself, because I didn't create you. I'm just a servant of the Most High God who was blessed to be redeemed from my oppressive ways, my oppressive mindset sets multiple. And I've been given an opportunity to do right because, you know, since I know better, I'm able to do better. And God has graced me with the opportunity to have a ministry that's unconventional, that's going to help you become the man or woman, if you're watching, you know, that God created for you to become, so that you can live your full life, the full life that God has for you. But not only a full life, life and life more abundantly, as the word says. And so definitely check out the description box. I also have other platforms that I'm on, whether it's TikTok, Instagram, Facebook. Also, if you want to support my platform as well, Ali, I have that all that information in there. So definitely check it out. So I just wanted to come on, you know, I wanted to come on here and you know, in part of me being more consistent, you know, when it comes to the content that I create, I wanted to come on here and again, even if it's a 5-minute video or 3-minute video, just come on here and encourage you. Let me take this light off a little bit. All right. So I just wanted to encourage you and to let you know that, you know what I'm saying, that God loves you. God wants the best for you, but you have to love yourself as well. Okay. God can lay out, you know, the hopes, the plans, and the beautiful welfare that he has for you. Not welfare as in Section 8 and or governmental assistance, but welfare as in good tidings, good things, Godspeed, blessings, increase, favor, you know, all the good things that come from God. You know, God can have that for you, and it's already there for you according to the word of God. Excuse me. But if you don't want it, if you don't desire it, you're not going to have it. And I recently did a video rooted in Psalm 37:4. Should I say it was inspired by Psalm 37:4. Delight yourself in the Lord and he will give you the desires of your heart. And in that video, I talk about the revelation that I got even while doing the video, that the Lord, when it says delight yourself in the Lord and he will give you the desires of your heart, the Lord is the word. So we have to delight ourselves in the AKA word of God. Okay. We have to delight ourselves in the Lord, the word became flesh and what dwelt amongst us. And so in the word of God, God has laid up just the riches and the honor and the glory and the righteousness that he ascribes to, that he has established as the way of life that we can access when we seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. righteousness, and all these things will be added to us. Everything that God created for the human being to have a blessed life is in the kingdom of God. And if you're a born-again believer, you've received the kingdom of God. If you have the Holy Spirit in you, you have the kingdom of God in you. It's about you growing in the revelation and in the understanding of what that means, what God meant by saying the kingdom of God is here, how you can now apply the principles and the tools and the revelations that is given to you because you're seeking God. It is a duty for the king. It is the duty for the king to seek out. It is the glory of a king. It's the glory of God to hide mysteries. It's the glory of a king to seek it out. So God has these mysteries and these revelations in his word that, you know, when we seek it out, when we meditate on his word day and night, when we show in our hearts that we want what our Father has for us, he's honored by that. He loves that. And in that process, you know, because of those works of faith, because you're believing that you're going to get something as far as not necessarily money, but you're believing that the more you seek God, the more you're going to discover who God is, because God is God. And you know, we have to desire him. We have to want him. This is why he's asking us to make these decisions, because he made us to have a free will. Okay. And so with us exercising our free will, we are saying to God, hey, God, we want to know more about you. Okay. We can exercise our free will when it comes to other things. Okay. That serves no purpose. I can testify of the things that I allocated my time and my resources to that served me no purpose, but other than to add to the oppression and the hurt and the pain and the hypocrisy and the falsehood that I subscribe to because I didn't know better. So I know you're watching this because you can't relate, and maybe you're now in a season where you're desiring truth. Maybe you're in a season right now where you're seeking the kingdom of God, but in a way that you don't necessarily understand clearly, but you know something is calling you, something is pulling you towards just seeking more truth. And just maybe now God is stripping you of relationships, people, places, and things that is communicated as you not wanting to have nothing to do with them. You feel like, oh, you know, there's nothing in common with people that you had a lot of stuff in common with, right? So this is all a part of the process of God elevating you and delivering you from the people, places, and things that he knew all the time, no longer didn't serve you, never served you. But because we had definitions of love, mercy, and loyalty that was perverted and corrupted, we wasn't able to really see what we needed to see. But glory to God for his faithfulness. Glory to God for his mercies and his loving kindness and his vigilant watch over our lives. Where now we're able to make decisions that pleases our Heavenly Father. We're able to make decisions that aligns with who God says we are, to embody the identity and the character and the nature that he says we are in Christ Jesus. And it is a pleasure. It's a blessing. It's an honor to be able to live life again, to do life again with God, and to live life where we know our God, where we know the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, where we know God who, you know what I'm saying, been watching over us, but we didn't know it for whatever reasons. You know, we were in bondage, we were blinded by the enemy. But now that we've been awakened, glory to God, now that according to Isaiah 61, you know, the Spirit of the Sovereign Lord has anointed me, right, has empowered me, has awakened me, okay, the resurrection power of the Holy Spirit that rose Christ from the dead now lives in us. Many of us who are dead in our transgressions, dead in our sins, okay, maybe not a physical death, but a spiritual death. So we were disconnected from God and we couldn't hear or see or discern God. But glory to God for his restoration and the grace that has been dispensed to us, those of us whom he has preserved, those of us whom he considers his remnant, those of us whom he has, you know, preserved and said, okay, you know, this is the group of people, these are the individuals, myself and everyone else who's watching, you know what I'm saying, that I'm going to set aside for myself, and they're going to be my people. I'm going to be their God. They're going to serve me, and I'm going to provide for them, and I'm going to take care of them. I'm going to be their reward, and they're going to glorify my name. I that's me. Okay. And so God has given me this ministry, CLG Lifestyle, which is abbreviated for Christ Loves God. It is, you know, it is my name abbreviated, but the revelation, you know, ultimately everything that I do is to glorify God. And it just made sense because that's how God is. God is able to work all things out for the good of those who love God, but also as predestined people called to God's promises, called to his purpose. As you go, you're going to see how everything has been aligned, how everything is just working out in a way that it could only have been God, because he is such perfect precision. He is such perfect alignment, you know, and if he is, you know, the beginning and the end, Alpha and Omega, then it will make sense why he would be privy and knowledgeable of things that we know nothing about and that we're now coming into the revelation about. So I just wanted to encourage you guys and to let you guys know, okay, that, you know, God has a plan for you. Jeremiah 29:11, you know what I'm saying, wasn't just made up. It's the word of God. The word of God is spirit and life. And we are in a season now where God is bringing all of his promises, all of his promises, all of his desires concerning us. He's bringing it to fruition. And it's about us, again, coming into agreement. It's about us accepting God's will for our life. It's about us desiring to do the will of our Heavenly Father, to be about our Father's business, and to become unapologetic and uncompromising about it, because God has been unapologetic and uncompromising about his plans and his desires to save us. Because if it was up to the enemy, many of us would have been dead a long time ago. If it was up to the enemy and the kingdom of darkness, you know what I'm saying? If they had it their way, we would be nothing, okay? Many of us would have been dead a long time ago. But God, in his loving kindness and in his mercy, has made a way for us to be redeemed. He's made a way for us to be freed from the bondage, from the darkness of the enemy, who, you know, God has called us out of darkness into his marvelous light. And it's a blessed time, and it's a blessed era. It's a blessed age to be born in a time such as this, because God is blessing his people, okay? So that's about it. I just wanted to, again, encourage you and remind you that you are loved, that God loves you. He wants the best for you, but you have to rise up. You have to want what God wants. You have to understand that God is not a man that he should lie, okay? And that his desires for us is not to harm us or to hurt us, but to give us a future, hope, and a blessed end. So I pray that you're encouraged. I pray that this video, I know I was talking fast, but I don't know what it is, but I just felt like I had to get this out. I feel like I've been bubbling and itching, and you know, I needed to get this out, because that's just how the Spirit of God works. You know, when you've made a decision to follow the Lord and to do what you believe is right in his eyes, when it comes to living by faith and being sold out, God will move and do some things that will shock you. It will shock the people who once knew you. It will shock yourself, because you're going to say like, whoa, where did this man come from? Where did this woman come from? I didn't know I had that in me. Yeah, you didn't know, because you didn't know. But now that you do, you know, now and again, as you grow more and more in the revelation as to who you are and who God is, man, what a life. What a life. So I pray you receive that, and I pray again that that God continues to bless this ministry, that I'm able to increase and in not only in influence, but also how I'm able to bless you guys. I want to start doing giveaways. I want to start taking you guys on some like global trips. You know, I want to start giving you more insight about my life, as far as like me, my plans to have, you know, move into my own place and get my own car, you know, and you know, love life, you know what I'm saying, back to school, educating myself, going to school, and really being restored. God is restoring my life. God is doing, you know, God is really watching over his word to perform it. And if it pleases him to be able to communicate that through the form of media, my life and what he's doing, not to brag, not to boast, not to say aha, you know what I'm saying, not to have that nanny boo boo spirit, you know what I'm saying, but to glorify God, to show you the love of God, the grace of God, the mercies of God, the faithfulness of God, the God who is a covenant keeping God, who is keeping his promises that he's made with my ancestors, God knows when. But he's watching over his word to perform it, because I am the one. You are the one that's been chosen for a time such as this to fulfill the promises of God that are yes and amen. Not one word shall drop to the ground concerning you, concerning the promises of God for your life. Amen. So I pray again that this video, which I believe is just filled with the anointing, because I could feel the glory of God right now. And I just pray that the power and everything that's associated with what I created tonight, that God blows upon it, that your heart is open, that your mind is receptive, that again, you begin to just have a fire for life, a love for life like never before, and to be about your Father's business. I think I'm going to start using that tagline. I'm going to create something about, you know, being about your Father's business, because that's really ultimately what Jesus said. You know, he told it to his mother at a very young age, and he said it in but so many other words in different ways. When people was inquiring about what he was doing, or, you know, when the Pharisees and the Sadducees, you know, was questioning his authority, Jesus was basically saying, I'm about my Father's business. If you got a problem with it, take it to him. You know, and that's really the attitude and the mentality that we need to have and that we should have in this place, so that we're not caught up arguing with people, defending who we are in front of people. Let God do the work. The Lord says, you know, my Father is always working. So let God, who is always working, work through you as a result of your active relationship with God, because there's so much rest in that. Let me tell you something. There's no other navigator, discerner, insightful, wisdom-filled entity than the Holy Spirit. Stay connected to God. That's where your work is at. That's where your labor is in, is in the Word of God and discovering who you are in the Word of God. Delight yourself in the Lord. Delight yourself in the Word of God, and He will give you the desires of your heart. He will give you His desires for your life. Since we were predestined in Christ Jesus to serve God, God has a life for us. God has a destiny for us that He has to download into us so that we can now come into agreement with His plans, His perspective, His will for our lives, and begin to speak His promises, begin to desire His promises, begin to want His promises, and walk out the faith, execute the faith that is associated or that will be complementary to what it is that we need to do as God's people, as God's sons, as God's servants, as His beloved, as His children. We are about our Father's business on this platform. The devil is dead. He's been dead, but he's even more dead in the lives of those of us whom God has again awakened, whom He has given us revelation about our authority, our dominion, and the power that He's given us, just like Jesus. Jesus said, greater work shall we do in His name. Okay? So God has given us, God has said, you are my faithful servant with whom I'm well pleased. I am His faithful servant with whom He's well pleased. So our lives are going to continue to glorify God. We are going to be walking, living billboards of the goodness of God. Amen? We are going to be the restorers of the promises of God for our bloodlines because we have repented. We have acknowledged our wrongdoings. We've been remorseful. Okay. We've turned from our wicked ways and we are desiring to do the things of our Father wants us to do. It doesn't mean that you're necessarily perfect, but our intentions are to please our Heavenly Father, and God is pleased with that. And He'll take the little that you do have and give you the much, much, much that you need to be a force not to be reckoned with in the world. You know how they say he or she's a force to be reckoned with? No. You're going to be a force not to be reckoned with. Not to be reckoned with. So don't even pull up. Don't even try it. Because I'm a force not to be reckoned with, okay? So that being said, beautiful people, I am Corwin L. Gilliams from CLG Lifestyle. Christ loves God. God is doing some wonderful things in the realms of media, in the realms of entertainment. And I just happen to be a fortunate and blessed and grateful and thankful servant who is doing the will of the Father. And the Father is being glorified in Jesus' name. Amen. Talk to y'all soon. God bless.